Here is a sentence in correct French. Repeat after me. Je suis dans le train. Je crois qu'on aura du retard. But here is how French people would say it. Je suis dans le train, je crois qu'on aura du retard. And that is why it is so difficult to understand spoken French. Let's see how you can make sense of it. Let's dive into cutting the E in French. The story of the French language is largely cutting letters out of Latin and other languages. So first of all, when you have two vowels next to one another, one of them tend to be cut. That's why je in front of a vowel becomes j apostrophe. For example, je ai become j'ai. Repeat after me, j'ai, with an open e, not a e. J'ai. Again, j'ai. Good. And we have the same thing with le and la. As in, for example, le éléphant doesn't work. We say l'éléphant. Repeat after me, l'éléphant. The T is silent and P and H in French make the sound F. So repeat after me, l'éléphant. Once again, l'éléphant. Good. Another example we have is la amie. We never say that. We say l'ami, the friend. L'ami for a woman. Repeat after me. L'ami. L'ami. Good. Now, that's all correct French is probably what you learned at school, and that's very useful for exams. But in everyday fast spoken French, French people tend to cut the E even when it's not in front of a vowel, in front of a consonant, for example. We have je suis, I am, that's pretty simple. But it's very often pronounced suis or suis. Repeat after me, suis and suis. And that's only for spoken French. It is not the way that you're supposed to write it. Je is often the first word to get shortened. For example, je comprends pas. I don't understand. Je comprends pas. We remove the E in je and it becomes je comprends pas. Try to repeat after me. Je comprends pas. Je comprends pas. Here, the je sound in the J kind of becomes a che sound. Because we speak fast, it's not a very definite sound. Repeat after me again, je comprends pas. Now, je crois, for I believe becomes je crois. Repeat after me, je crois. It can be difficult to say, je crois. And it can happen almost any time the letter E, E en français, is actually pronounced E without any kind of accent. For instance, with le. Le train, the train, for instance, becomes train. Repeat after me, le train. Le train. Le train. Yes, the L sound is really difficult to say at the beginning, le train. Especially when I'm doing a lesson on this on purpose, because I kind of have to slow my fast spoken French, so it's tricky even for me. Another example, je suis dans le train. I am in the train becomes je suis dans le train. Repeat after me. Je suis dans le train. Again, je suis dans le train. Good. It can also be used on the reflective pronouns me, te, etc. As in, for example, je me lève. I am waking up or getting up. Je me lève. It can become two things here because you can remove two E. It can become je me lève. Repeat after me. Je me lève. Where we remove the E in me. Or we can remove the first E in je and it becomes je me lève. Repeat after me. Je me lève. Again, je me lève. Another example, tu te réveilles, you are waking up, tu te réveilles. This is the French that you learned at school. But we would say, tu te réveilles. Tu te réveilles. Repeat after me. Tu te réveilles. Here the S at the end of réveil is silent. It is the mark of the second person of the singular. And we remove the E in te. Tu te réveilles. If you want a trick for saying it, we say tu te réveilles. And then you say it faster and it becomes tu te réveilles. Say it again. Tu te réveilles. Tu te réveilles. Yes, good. Okay, so these were all small one-syllable words. Does this apply to longer words? Yes, it does. For instance, petit. Petit means small or short, and the final T in petit is silent. Repeat after me. Petit. Petit. Petit is often pronounced petit because we remove the E. Petit. Repeat after me. Petit. 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 In the sentence, c'est un petit train. It's a small train. C'est un petit train. Here, notice that I do la liaison between est and un, so it makes t'in. C'est un petit train becomes c'est un petit train. Repeat after me. C'est un petit train. Again, c'est un petit train. Here we have several elements to say properly. We have la liaison entre c'est and un, c'est un. We have the E that disappears in petit. We have the un sound as well in train, and the T in petit is silent. So all this makes, repeat after me again, c'est un petit train. C'est un petit train. And this also applies to any kinds of random words with the E sound. For example, le retard, lateness. Here you can notice that the D in retard is silent. We don't say it. Le retard becomes le retard when we remove the E. Repeat after me. Le retard. Le retard. Good. As in, on aura du retard becomes on aura du retard. On aura du retard. Here you can notice as well the liaison between on and aura. We don't say on aura, we say on aura. There's a liaison between the N of on and the A of aura. On aura. Repeat after me. On aura du retard. Again, on aura du retard. Yes, it is not easy to say. And now you can understand the sentences that we saw at the beginning of the lesson, remember? Je suis dans le train, je crois qu'on aura du retard. That's textbook French. But we would say, je suis dans le train, je crois qu'on aura du retard. Try to say it. Je suis dans le train. Je crois qu'on aura du retard. Once again. Je suis dans le train. Je crois qu'on aura du retard. Félicitations. Now you understand a bit better how French people cut the E. However, cutting the E doesn't always work, or at least it is not that simple. Sorry. First of all, it is going to depend on your accent and the French region where you are or where French people are from. For example, French people from the south of France tend to cut their E much less than people from Paris, where they tend to speak much faster. The second thing is that it only works when the E sound like a E sound, when there is no accent, remember? So when there is a E or a E, for example, in un éléphant, éléphant, the elephant, you cannot shorten it in un éléphant or un éléphant. No, it doesn't work like that. The third problem is a little bit more subtle. Cutting the E is everywhere, but don't overdo it. We would say je me lève or je me lève, but not je me lève. That's a little bit too hard to say. When you cut too many E, it makes it too hard to pronounce. It's the subtle difference between samedi for Saturday instead of samedi and mercredi that never becomes mergi because we cannot say it. When you can't say the word, it doesn't make your speech any faster. Finally, for longer words, cutting the E is no longer informal. It became the standard pronunciation of this French word. For instance, parfaitement, for perfectly. We never say it like this. We never say parfaitement. We cut the E in the middle and it becomes parfaitement. Repeat after me. Parfaitement. Parfaitement. The T at the end is silent. We also have totalement for totally. We never say it like that. We never say totalement. We cut the E and say totalement. Repeat after me. Totalement. Totalement. Good. And now you are ready to practice cutting the E in French. Félicitations! Practice understanding fast spoken French with a real scene from a French movie. Click on your screen to access the next video on the playlist. You will also get to learn more about French accents and spoken French essentials. I will see you in the next video. À tout de suite!